Blessed be the name of the Lord. As Christians, we need to understand the times and seasons. It will benefit you greatly to know what God's plan is for your life, what God's plan is for the next 3 months, 1 year, 10 years, for your country, for your town, for your family. Then you will know what to do. Should you get that job? Should you move or should you stay? Should you hide or run? I want to explain something about understanding times and seasons. In Matthew 16:21, there is a story about failing to understand the times and seasons. And that comes from Peter, the famous disciple of Jesus. It says, from that time, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things from the elders and chief priests and scribes and be killed, and on the third day be raised. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. Far be it from you, Lord, this shall never happen to you. But Jesus turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. This is the famous, get thee behind me, Satan. You are a hindrance to me, for you are not setting your mind on the things of God, but on the things of man. Was Jesus too hard on Peter? Get thee behind me, Satan. That seems pretty harsh. Very few people understand times and seasons. If you know what times you are in, then you know if it's God's will for something to happen. Then you understand if you should be prepping or investing or running or hiding. There are more stories in the Bible about how the disciples of Jesus and other Jews missed the point and acted on their own, by their own understanding, without knowing times and seasons, without knowing God's plan. There's a story in Acts chapter 5 about one wise rabbi called Gamaliel. He was a Pharisee and he had the right attitude. He had wisdom and understanding of times and seasons. Maybe not completely, but at least he had the right attitude. In chapter 5, Peter and the disciples, they preached the gospel in Jerusalem and they were being persecuted by the Pharisees and even sent to prison. And then angels freed them up, they got out of prison, and then the Pharisees went after them again. But this time, this one Pharisee in the council named Gamaliel stood up and he said, take care what you are about to do with these men, with Peter and other new Christians. He said, there were other people before who tried to create a movement and nobody joined, and they were either killed or they dispersed, and the movements came to nothing. Because he said, if it's from God, then you will not be able to overthrow it. But if it's not from God, it's going to just wither away. But if it is from God, you fight against the movement, in this case Christianity, you might be found opposing God. So they took his advice. And those were very wise words. And it turned out that the movement, Christianity, was from God. And the Pharisees were not able to stop it because they were fighting God, arresting Christians, and in the end they failed. Because the time and the season was to take the gospel to the Gentiles, and it was to put the Jews on the back burner. I'm not talking about the replacement theology. It was the time to focus on the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles come to an end and put the Jews on the back burner. There are many more similar accounts in the Bible about people missing the point and not understanding times and seasons. There is one about Jerusalem being destroyed in AD 70, and the Romans came to Jerusalem, they razed the temple to the ground, and the Jews were either killed or sent out and taken into slavery, and Jesus warned his contemporaries about that. He warned them that the temple will be destroyed, that it was over, but they didn't listen to him. They wanted to make Jerusalem great again. They wanted to restore the glory of Israel, and they wanted to go back to normal because they wanted to continue their way of life. But Jesus prophesied about the end of that era. Israel was done, and some Christians believed Jesus and they left Jerusalem. There are Christian sources confirming that before the temple was destroyed in AD 70 and so many Jews were killed and taken into slavery, early Christians, they were warned to flee, And they went to the region of Decapolis, which was across the Jordan River, which is basically where the country of Jordan is now today. There was a city called Pella, and they left Judea, they went to Pella, and they survived. They hid in Pella. They were able to survive as Christians, and then later they took the gospel to other countries. But other Jews, the ones who wanted to make Israel great again, they died because it wasn't God's plan for them to win with Rome. So Rome defeated them. You need to understand times and seasons we are in. Very few people understand times and seasons, probably about 10%. How do I know the number? Because that's the pattern from the Old Testament. In Genesis 35, we read about the sons of Leah and Jacob, and one of them was Issachar. He was one of the 12 children. This is about the 12 tribes of Israel. And he was the only one of 12, who understood the times and seasons. In Genesis 49, there are prophecies about them, about every tribe, predictions about each one of the 12 children of Jacob who became the heads of the 12 tribes of Israel. And about Issachar, it says that he is a strong donkey crouching between the sheepfolds. He saw that a resting place was good and that the land was pleasant. So he bowed his shoulder to bear and became a servant at forced labor. I remember when I read about that the first time, I asked God not to be like Issachar, not to live in the spirit of Issachar, because I didn't want to bow my shoulder to forced labor. It's funny how God works things out, because now, some years, about 15 years later, God took us out of Babylon and we are homesteading, and I may not be crouching between sheepfolds because we have no sheep, but we have chickens. And we have a resting place that is our refuge, the land that God gave us, our place, our land that is pleasant, and there's lots of physical work involved at the homestead. But it's not all bad. It's not all about physical work and hard labor. There's an upside to living in the spirit of Issachar, and the upside is understanding the times and seasons. In 1 Chronicles 12:32, we read that Issachar, which also means all the men from the tribe of Issachar, and today it's the people who live in the spirit of Issachar, they have the understanding of times and seasons. They know, it says in the Bible, they know what Israel ought to do at certain time, which means they see the direction their country is going. They see the steps they need to take. And they see also where the world is going, they connect the dots, and they understand the times. And if you do that with your life, then you don't end up fighting God. It's good not to live in the dark when it comes to God's plan for us, right? It says in Jeremiah 8 that even the stork knows her appointed times, and the turtle and the crane and the swallow observe the time of their coming, but my people know not the judgment of the Lord. Many people don't understand the times we are in, the end times. Should we try to restore the Western democracies back to their former glory? Or maybe this is it. Maybe the times of the Gentiles are finished and we are approaching the time of the second coming. Ask God to give you the understanding of the times and seasons. When you watch the animals, and that's what Jeremiah 8 is talking about, they know their times and seasons. When you live in the countryside, you see how before the winter comes, the foxes increase the frequency of circling the house, looking for food. The squirrels gather a lot of stuff and they hide it all. The last week before you get the Arctic grip, the deep freeze of winter, all the animals are so busy getting ready for the cold months. They don't have the weather forecasts, but they know the times and the seasons. And so should we. Issachar was one tribe out of 12 who understood times and seasons. And we need that too. As a Christian, it will benefit you greatly to know what God is up to. So ask Him for that gift, ask Him for wisdom, ask Him to give you that the ability of the spirit of Issachar to understand the times and seasons. And may he richly bless you from Zion. Take care. Bye-bye.